What's going on, everybody? Welcome to this video. Today I'm going to show you my pick and predictions for Worlds 2022. Please let me know in the comments below if you agree or disagree. Of course, I'm going to show you or share my thoughts and everything about these picks, why I select the teams to be ranked in the order I'm going to. So let's first start with Group D, because this is probably the easiest group to select. Of course, you never know what is going to happen, but I think CTBC Flying Oyster from the PCS is going to be last, just because they don't have any international experience. I think that 100 Thieves, they are still quite good, to be honest, even though I'm not convinced by the LEC, by the NALCS over the last years, but still I think they should be better than the PCS, especially because it's the second team coming into Worlds from NA, and I think they have international experience, and I think that they are not as bad as you might think. So 100 Thieves third place, and RNG and Gen G, to be honest, Gen G first seed from Korea, they played very, very well, and RNG, they had to qualify through the play-in stages. However, apart from the loss against DRX, which was also a quite close game, to be honest, I think that they performed well, and RNG, everybody in the League of Legends world knows this name, and I think they are going to perform. However, Gen G, same thing, international experienced, everybody should know the name Gen G. They have very, very good players, so I think Gen G should be ranked above RNG. We can get a little comparison of the two teams, especially I think Ruler, Peanut from Gen G, they just have so much experience. Also Jovi coming in, they have very, very much international experience. But also Xiaohu from RNG, Gala and Ming, also very, very experienced players. But I think Gen G is just because they are performing better at the moment than RNG is performing. RNG, they had their peak in the spring, split, and Gen G, they just performed during the playoffs, and that's why I think Gen G should be ranked higher than RNG. Okay, the other three groups, I think, to be honest, they are very hard to predict, because I really can't decide about the fact that the LEC teams, they all of them struggled to perform when it mattered, apart from Rogue. Okay, so let's start with Group A, because it's just alphabetic order. Cloud9, first seed, so let's put it like this. They are in the first pool, T1 second pool, then EDG third pool, and Fnatic fourth pool. So that's not my ranking. This is just how they were ranked according to the seeding. I think I have to put Cloud9 to the very bottom, but I cannot decide to switch it with Fnatic. We will see that in just a second. Okay, so for the first place, T1 against EDG. To be honest, I just have to place T1 above EDG, just because they have Faker, and Faker always performs when it matters. You cannot say anything against that. So I'm just going to place them this way. So T1 first, Edward Gaming second, and then Cloud9 against Fnatic. So usually I would always put LEC above LCS, just because of the performances in the past World Championships. But this year I'm really not convinced with Fnatic. I think they have a very good bottom laner, so Upset, he's a very, very good ADC. But Hillisang is really struggling. The only thing that I think where Fnatic can really surprise opponents is if they are going to swap in rooks again. I don't know if he's allowed to play there because he was playing in the playing stages because Hillisang had COVID. So he swapped in there. I don't know if he's still in the roster, and I'm not informed about how many players you are allowed to take with you in the main event. Sven as a support for Cloud9 worked out quite well. Still, I think that he should be an ADC. I mean, Berserker, he did quite well. He just doesn't have that much experience, but of course, you have to get the experience from somewhere, and there are players like Faker who didn't have any experience at the beginning and still performed. So I'm just saying that he doesn't have that much international experience. Jensen, Blabber and Fudge, they are quite good, but they, just because of the names, they usually shouldn't be as good as the Fnatic laners. But I'm still, okay, just because Cloud9 performed very well in the regular season and Fnatic didn't, I'm going to place Cloud9 above Fnatic. My gut feeling kind of tells me not to, but maybe just because I'm a Fnatic fan, but I'm going to do it this way, just because Cloud9 performed during the regular season, and no matter what I'm going to tell you now, they still performed well and Fnatic didn't. Okay, Group B. Damwonkia, Evil Geniuses, G2 Esports and JD Gaming. So again, let's do the ranking according to the play-in seeding. So that's G2 second, Damwonkia third, and Evil Geniuses, they had to go through the play-in stage. I think this is quite well, to be honest. Evil Geniuses, I think we can all agree, even though they performed very well in the play-in stage, and when it mattered, they performed quite well. They won their tiebreakers. They won 3-0 against Mad Lions. Even though, okay, I think Mad Lions didn't perform perfect, but Evil Geniuses performed really, really well. So they just won the game because they performed well and not because Mad Lions were underperforming. So that was well deserved that they got into the main stage, but I still think that they aren't just as good as the three remaining teams. So G2 Esports, okay, you always have the caps buff. The problem is that they have to compete against JD Gaming, who won the LPL, and they have to perform against Damwonkia, who have like huge names. They have Showmaker, Canyon and Nuggery, and like I can't really tell you who is going to win in this game. This is going to be a kind of 50-50. So I think JD Gaming, by the way, let me know if you disagree, but I think JD Gaming, they should be ranked first because they performed really well in the summer split during the LPL. And G2 Esports is really depending on if they can perform in the group stage. So if G2 Esports and Damwonkia are playing a good game, then I would probably rank Damwonkia above G2 Esports. The thing here is that G2 Esports, they can have very, 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 very good games, whereas Damwonkia, they are kind of more stable. That's my opinion. You don't have to agree with that. So I think G2 Esports, they have a higher peak, they have higher highs than Damwonkia, but they also have lower lows than Damwonkia. So I really think that this is kind of a 50-50 one. I kind of want to place G2 Esports also there because I really want a team from the LEC, from Europe, again performing well on Worlds. And I think it would be very boring again if it was just LPL against LCK during the complete knockout stage. So that's why I'm placing G2 Esports there. It's still very much kind of 50-50. So the thing is, G2 Esports, they played well apart from their loss against Rogue in the finals. So I think you should place them second place and Damwonkia third place. Okay, so that's it about Group B. Let's get to Group C. Rogue, Gam Esports, DRX and Top Esports. So again, the ranking was like this. Rogue from the LEC, Top Esports, LPL, so from China, VCS, Vietnam, and LCK from Korea, so the DRX from Korea. DRX, they just went through the playing stages as we would have expected, 5-0. So we saw five games from them, but only one was challenging against RNG. So I cannot really tell you much about their performance so far in Worlds. Still, they are a team from Korea. They have a very, very nice roster. Just the, I think their bot lane is probably, I think you cannot disagree with that. Their bot lane is probably the one of the best bot lanes, if not the best bot lane in the in Group C, with Deft and Beryl. So they should be ranked higher than GAM Esports. So I think we have to rank GAM Esports at place 4, even though they, the VCS, they performed very well in last in their last Worlds experience, especially GAM Esports. I can only think back to their destruction of Fnatic, I think 2 or 3 years ago, when they picked a Nocturne and really leashed through his jungle. Nocturne was level 6 when the bot lane was level 3, and he just ganked with an ultimate, and Fnatic was just caught off guard, and they just destroyed Fnatic. Still, they didn't qualify, because in the next game, Fnatic was prepared, and all the other teams were prepared. So I think everybody knows from now on that GAM Esports is going to throw everything at them that they have, and they have to be very careful. So I think GAM Esports, they may win one game, but they are probably going to finish fourth in this group. Then Rogue, Top Esports, and DRX. The problem here is that Rogue probably has the worst group possible. Of course, with DRX coming in as the best play-in team, probably. Still, they performed very well. They overperformed throughout the whole season. I think they surprised every analyst. The problem is that they still have to perform on the international stage. So I'm struggling to put them above Top Esports and DRX, just because the bot lane of Rogue, Comp and Trimby, they have to play against Jackie Love and Deft. So I think I have to put it this way. The difference between Top Esports and DRX is just that Top Esports, they were second during the spring split, second during the summer split. So second seed from the LPL. They are a very stable team. They don't have huge ups and downs. They're a very stable team, and I think DRX could be difficult for them, but I think the bot lane is going to be kind of 50-50, but in the other lanes, Top Esports is just going to be stronger with Knight, Tian, especially the mid jungle duo is going to outperform the DRX jungle mid lane duo. Of course, Pioshik is quite nice, but in Seca and Kingen, the solo laners from DRX, they are not as good as the solo laners from Top Esports. Between Rogue and DRX, I really struggle putting these two teams, because Rogue, again, they always surprised me. The bot lane is just going to lose against DRX. Larsen is probably going to win the mid lane. Oduamne, kind of also 50-50. Malrang, he played very, very well, to be honest. I really want to put Rogue above DRX. I'm not going to doubt Rogue again, so I have to place them in second place. Just because I always underestimated them, I'm not going to do this again. So, Group A, T1, Edward Gaming, Cloud9, Fnatic. Let me know in the comments if you disagree with any of my picks. Group B, JD Gaming, G2 Esports, Damwon Kia, Evil Geniuses. Group C, Top Esports, Rogue, DRX, GAM Esports. And Group D, Gen G, RNG, 100 Thieves, and CTBC Flying Oyster in 4th place. I think, to be honest, LCK and LPL, they are very, very good this year. Those are my predictions. Please, again, let me know in the comments below if you agree or disagree. Thank you for watching, and hopefully see you in the next video. Bye!